Hi there. I'd like to show you what I've been working on this past month. It's called MoonTaxi. What is MoonTaxi? MoonTaxi is a game where you control a little moonlander with asymmetric thrusters. That's one thruster on the left side of the ship and one thruster on the right. Using the thrusters, the player can fly over the surface of a low-gravity moon. Using the information shown in the waypoint panel at the bottom of the screen, the player can navigate to locations in the game world. Here we see our intrepid lander guy coasting in for a landing back at home base. Make sure you don't run out of fuel. Above the waypoint panel, the player can find the altitude, position, their distance to their waypoint, as well as their velocity broken out into vertical and horizontal components. Above the fuel gauge, warning lights indicate if the player is flying slowly enough to safely land. Setting down gently now on the landing pad, and not a moment too soon as the fuel level is almost completely depleted. No worries. Pop into the station services and grab a full tank of MoonTaxi fuel. While you're in the station, why not try one of the mini-games on offer? In the Go Ballistic mini-game, a target is generated at a random location to the west or to the east, and the player tries to land as close to the target as they can. The one wrinkle is you only get 10 seconds of thrust after you take off. So the goal is to set yourself on a ballistic trajectory that lands near the target. Hence the name, Go Ballistic. Now I've taken off, I've used my 10 seconds of thrust. I'm using the time compression function that I programmed in, and now I'm coming in for landing. And hey, I'd say that's pretty good. You landed with inside of 300 meters to the target. That's not too bad. See, not so bad. So you get some credits for that. You continue and it takes you back to the spawning point. You can also try moon skimming. The goal with moon skimming is to fly as low and as fast as you dare using the wonky, janky, asymmetric flying system that the ship has. So you follow your waypoint over to the right. And it says start in the gate. You fly through the gate, and look at that. It starts keeping score. You get score. You get every frame, you get 100 points minus your altitude times some kind of velocity multiplier. And you add that every single frame onto your total score, and that's how that works. Oh boy, pretty close to crashing there. So you keep flying all the way through. You see there the waypoint screen you're following to the finishing gate. Still got about 500 meters to go. I fly through the finishing gate, and it awards me, no credits because that part's not working right. And neither is the top score thing. It's not done yet, but it will be. So you finish that, and now the player gets, you know, you're back to the normal flying mode, and although I didn't set a waypoint here, I happen to know that there's a landing pad right over here, so I'm going to go and grab a landing. When you're landed, instead of doing a minigame, you could also take a job. At the moment, the jobs are pretty simple. They just generate an origin and a destination from the options. So basically, someone is telling you to fly from where you are to up to the ridgetop. I'm going to fly up to the ridgetop. Let me set my waypoint to ridgetop. I can see I have to fly 2,600 meters west and 570 meters above where I am. So I take off and I'm heading over this way. And now we're coming in for landing after I wildly overshot the target. Bringing it in here for a nice little set down here. And after you come in for landing, you can go back onto the job screen and you can get paid for the job that you just completed. After you fill up your fuel, complete your contract, get paid, get some experience points, which don't do anything yet, but they will. And that's pretty much where I'm at with my game. MoonTaxi, after about a month of working every day on it.